This is a video for 2T VWO. It's about chapter 9, linear equations. I'm going to discuss exercise 31. And in exercise 31, it says, solve the following inequalities. Write your answer as a fraction. Okay, I'm going to do that. This was the first one. Minus 18 plus 5x is greater than 12 plus 2x. Now, I find it important that you also understand the theory behind it. So I'm going to make a drawing first. I'm only going to do it with the first one, and the rest of it I'm just going to solve by doing the balance method. But this one I'm going to make a picture. This is a linear line. The gradient is a positive 5, so the line goes up. And this is a linear line. The gradient is 2, so the line also goes up, but a little bit slower. It starts at a higher point, 12, and this one starts at minus 18. Okay, now this is the intersection point, and the question is, when is this formula, so that's this one, this line, greater than the other one? I believe here it's greater than the other one. So from this intersection point on, and then further. Okay, and now I'm going to solve it by doing the balance method. Minus 2x on this side, minus 2x on that side. So this becomes minus 18 plus 3x. The 2x is gone. And then plus 18 on this side, plus 18 on that side. 12 plus 18 is 30. And then divide by the number in front of the x, divided by 3 on this side, divided by 3 on the other side. So that becomes 10. So this intersection point is at 10. And then it's from this intersection point on, towards the other side, it's greater than 10. So x is greater than 10 when this statement is true. And b, 2/3 x plus 8 is smaller than 7/12 x minus 5. Okay, so I see fractions here. It doesn't need to bother you, you just have to take it slow. Now, first, minus 7/12 x on this side, minus 7/12 x on that side. Perhaps you find this hard. Here's a trick that is helpful. You just copy the 2/3 x and you just write down behind it minus 7/12 x and then plus 8. And then you will just fix this later. Minus 5. First, I'm going to do minus 8 on this side, minus 8 on that side. And just copy this again. Minus 8 here becomes minus 13. And now I'm going to solve this problem. So the denominators are 3 and 12. So I'm going to make this 12 as well. I'm going to do that by doing the denominator, so the bottom one, times 4, and the numerator also times 4. So that's 8 12 x. 2 times 4 is 8, 3 times 4 is 12. And this one stays the same. And 8 12th x minus 7 12th x, now it looks a lot easier. You just do the numerators minus each other. 8 minus 7 is 1. So it's 1 12th x. Of course, if you want to do this in one step or already here, that's also fine. This is just a trick to make it kind of easier for yourself. Now, divide by the number in front of the x. So divide by 1 12th on this side, divide by 1 12th on this side. If you divide by a fraction, it's actually doing times the opposite of the fraction. So I believe that this is doing times 12. Makes sense. 1 12th times 12 is 1. And minus 13 times 12 is minus 156. So its x is smaller than minus 156. C, 7 brackets x minus 2 is smaller than 3x minus 26. First, remove the brackets. 7 times x is 7x. 7 times minus 2 is minus 14. And then smaller than, you just copy everything. Minus 3x on this side, minus 3x on that side. Plus 14 on this side, plus 14 on that side. And divided by 4 here, divided by 4 here. You divide by a positive number, so the symbol doesn't change at all. If you divide by a negative number, the symbol just changes. Doesn't matter if it's smaller than or greater than, it just changes. So divided by 4 on both sides, so this is minus 3. Also brackets, copy everything and then remove the brackets. 2 times 3x is 6x and 2 times minus 26 is minus 52. And then minus 6x here, minus 6x there. This is a 1. And 1 minus 6 is minus 5x. And then minus 3 on this side, minus 3 on that side. This is minus 55. Now, you come to the moment you have to do divided by. And I can see that there's a negative number in front of the x. So you have to divide it by minus 5 on this side and divide by minus 5 on this side. And when you have to do divided by with these inequalities, that means that this symbol is changing the other way around. So, yeah, it just changes. And then minus divided by minus is positive. 55 divided by 5 is 11. So x is greater than 11. Let me show it to you in a picture. This is a line that goes up a little bit slow. And this is a line that goes up as well, but a little bit faster. And this is the intersection point. The intersection point is at 11. And the question was, when is this line that goes up slow smaller than the line that goes up a little bit faster? When is this line smaller? I believe that's here. Because here it's lower than this line. Let me extend it a little bit. Here it's lower than that line. And here this is higher, greater than the other one. Okay, so everything from the intersection point on, greater, because to the right is greater and to the left is smaller. So from 11 on, greater, this is indeed smaller. This formula, this graph is indeed smaller than the other graph. So yes, it's this is correct. X is greater than 11. A half times 14 is 7, and a half times minus 8x is minus 4x. Plus x on this side, plus x on that side. And minus 7 here, minus 7 there. Divided by minus 3 on this side, divided by minus 3 on this side. So that's divided by a negative number. That means that symbol is changing. X. So it's 14 divided by minus 3. I already know the answer is going to be negative. How many whole numbers are there in 14? I believe 4. So 4 whole numbers. And the leftover is, because 12 divided by 3 is 4, leftover is 2/3. So you can do this easily without a calculator by doing first writing down this and then take the whole numbers out. So the answer is x is smaller than minus 4/2. And the last one, 3 times 2x is 6x. And also 3 times minus 4 is minus 12. Minus 2 times x is minus 2x. And minus 2 times 8 is minus 16. Then the letters plus 2x here, plus 2x there. Plus 12 here, plus 12 there. And plus 12 is minus 4. Divide by a positive number, so the symbol stays the same. Divide by 8, and also divided by 8 here. Minus 4 divided by 8 is a negative number, and 4 divided by 8 is a half, so minus a half. By the way, and I forgot to tell you, in the book they use a kind of a number line here, and then you have to use the letters C and N, so correct and not correct. And this is explained in exercise 28 and also in the method on page 79 of your book. So you can see that number line there and the C and N. So this is also a good way to understand what kind of symbol needs to be here. But it's your own choice. What I do is I copy the symbol with all the steps and then only with the last step, with divided by. When I divide by a negative number, then I just change the symbol. And when I divide by a positive number, then the symbol stays the same. And that's what I prefer. But you, if you want to make a number line, that's fine. It's up to you. Now, something else. If you check your answers, which is obligated, you have to check your answers with the answer book. You have to use the answer book in Magister and not your own answer booklet. This is very important because the answers in Magister, it includes all the steps, all the calculations, everything. And all the steps are important. When there is a test, for example, you're not allowed to only write down the answer. You have to write down all the steps and you also get points for all these steps. So therefore, it's important to check it with the answers in Magister. Please do not use your own answer booklet. All right, so that was it for this exercise. I hope it was helpful. Thanks for watching. Bye.